வெல்கம் டு ஜியோகிராஃபி சமச்சீர் சிலபஸ் ஆஃப் தமிழ்நாடு கிளாஸ் 9 ஜியோகிராஃபி லெசன் 3 எக்ஸோஜெனடிக் ப்ராசஸஸ் பார்ட் 4 அண்ட் திஸ் இஸ் த லாஸ்ட் பார்ட் ஆஃப் திஸ் லெசன் அண்ட் இன் திஸ் பார்ட் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி அபவுட் த எரோஷனல் டிரான்ஸ்போர்டேஷனல் அண்ட் டெபாசிஷனல் ஒர்க் ஆஃப் விண்ட் அண்ட் வேவ்ஸ் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் லெட் அஸ் சி அபவுட் த ஆக்ஷன் ஆஃப் விண்ட் When air blows horizontally at or near the earth's surface, it is called wind. The erosional, transportational, and depositional action of wind is predominant in arid regions. What are arid regions? Arid regions are the dry areas or dry regions with barren land surface, and there will not be moisture. Otherwise, there will be very less moisture. And since there is no natural vegetation found there, there is no trees in arid regions to restrict or curtail the speed of the wind. So the action of the wind is predominant in the arid regions. And this is also called as Aeolian process. First, let us see about the erosional landforms of wind. Mushroom rock. The rocks are made up of hard and soft layers. We have studied about this in the first lesson itself. When a rock's bottom is soft, the sand laden and winds blow against it and wear it down. So the softer parts of the rock gets eroded fastly and initially. By the constant wearing down action of the wind, the bottom gets eroded away to form a mushroom-like structure. And this is called a mushroom pedestal rock. Such rocks are found near Jodhpur in Rajasthan. What is the other name of mushroom rock? It is pedestal rock. See this picture. This is the rock which is made up of soft rocks and hard rocks alternatively. And the soft rocks and hard rocks are placed alternatively horizontally. So the rock boulder in wind desert area, the wind carrying sand and small rocks abrade the bottom of the rock. And repeated wind action erodes more of the boulder away. Mushroom rock is formed thus. Further erosion can cause the rock to fall in. Inselberg. Inselberg is a German term which means an island mountain. Certain rocks like igneous rocks are more resistant to wind action. Such isolated residual hills rising abruptly from their surroundings are termed as inselbergs. Example, Uluru or IS rock in Australia. So this is Inselberg, which is also known as island rock. So here, when different types of rocks are found in an area, these rocks which are made up of igneous, the igneous rocks, they are more resistant to the action of the wind. So they get eroded very slowly and the rest of the rocks, they would have been worn out. And thus it results in the formation of Inselberg. And the best example of this Inselberg is Uluru or IS rock in Australia. Uluru is the aboriginal name of this IS rock, and it is believed that this IS rock was formed around 450 to 500 million years back. And Uluru means single pebble or large pebble. Air dam. In arid regions, certain rocks have hard and soft layers arranged vertically. So when they are arranged horizontally, the mushroom rocks are formed. When these hard rocks and soft rocks are arranged vertically, the soft rocks in between the hard rocks, they get eroded and they result in the formation of erdong. They look like irregular crust and these are called erdongs. Depositional landforms of wind. Some of the depositional landforms of sand dunes, barchans and loess. Sand dune. In deserts, during sandstorms, wind carries loads of sand. When the speed of wind decreases, huge amount of sand gets deposited. So, when the speed of the wind is increased, it goes on transporting the materials and the travel of the sand particles. It is a continuous process. But suddenly, when the speed of the wind gets decreased, the particles, sand particles carried away by the wind or get deposited in a particular place. And these mounds or hills of sand are called as sand dunes. And there are different types of sand dunes. Barchan, birch are isolated and crescent-shaped sand dunes. They have gentle slopes on the windward side and steep slopes on the leeward side. The next one is transverse dunes. These transverse dunes are asymmetrical in shape. They are formed by the alternative slow and fast winds that blow from the same direction. Longitudinal dunes, which are also called as sieve dunes. Longitudinal dunes are long, narrow ridges of sand which extend in their direction parallel to the prevailing winds. And these dunes are called sieves in Sahara Desert areas. Loess. The term loess refers to the deposits of fine silt and porous sand over a vast region. It looks light yellow in color actually. Extensive loess deposits are found in northern and western China. Especially you can see this in the part of Gobi Desert also. The Pampas of Argentina in Ukraine and in the Mississippi Valley of United States. The thickest known deposit of loess is 335 meters found in the loess plateau in China. Now, let us move on to the action of waves. A steady up and down movement of surface water are called caves. Sea waves are the most powerful agents of gradation, and their erosional, transportational, and depositional processes are confined to a very narrow belt along the coastal areas. It's natural. Erosional landforms of waves. Sea cliffs or steep rock faces form when sea waves dash against them. The rocks get eroded to form steep vertical walls. So this is the cliff, sea cliffs. And this steep vertical walls were formed because of the continuous action of the waves on them. And this area is called as headland. This area is called as headland. Sea cave. Prolonged wave attack on the base of cliff erodes. See here? So when continuously the waves, they keep on eroding the steep walls of the sea cliff. And this continuous prolonged action makes the caves to form. They result in the formation of caves. So caves are nothing but the hollows or holes formed on the steep-sided walls of the sea cliffs. When two caves approach one another from either side of the headland and unite, they form the structure which is called as arch. And this is the best example of the arch in Neel Island, which is found in Andaman and Nicobar of India. And this again, prolonged continuous action of the waves make this arch to disintegrate. The further erosion by waves ultimately leads to the total collapse of the arch. The seaward position of the headland will remain as a pillar known as stack. So this is stack. And when this stack continuously erodes and become very small in size, it is called as stump. So this is the arch and this is stump. Wave cut platforms. Flat surface found at the foot of the sea cliffs are called as wave cut platforms. Then this wave cut platform is also referred sometimes as wave cut benches or terrace. And if you see this picture, you can understand. This is the sea cliff and this area is called as headland. And initially, because of the action of the waves, these rocks, they get cracks here, and the further action of the waves make the cracks to enlarge, and that result in the formation of the sea cave, and further erosion of the sea cave on other side also, when the other side of this headland may also have a sea cave like this, and when these two sea caves, they approach each other and a hollow is formed here, and this is called a sea arch, and this further collapse of sea ice by the action of the sea waves result in the formation of sea stack, and this is called a sea stump. Now, depositional landforms of waves. Beach. Sand and gravel are moved and deposited by waves along the shore to form beaches. This is the most dominant and constructive work of the sea. Bar. A bar is an elongated deposit of sand, shingle or mud found in the sea. Almost, they are found parallel to the shoreline. Spit. A spit is a ridge or embankment of sediment attached to the land on one end and terminating in open water on the other end. Spits are common at the mouth of estuaries. A spit is an extended stretch of beach material that projects out to sea and is joined to the mainland at one end. And spits are formed where the prevailing wind blows at an angle to the coastline, resulting in longshore drift. And this is Kakinada spit, found in Andhra Pradesh in India. So with this, we come to the end of this lesson, exogenetic processes. Don't forget to like this video, give your feedback in the comment section, share it with your friends, and kindly subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.